Class 10, let us start. Today we are going to revise the chapter Nelson Mandela. But before I start, as we have revised it a number of times, so let me listen from you that what you people want to speak about Nelson Mandela or what you have learned through this chapter. Yes, Baljinder, stand up. What you have read in Nelson Mandela? Stand up. Sit down. Yes, Ameeksha. What about Nelson Mandela? You remember? Very bad. All the children are blank. Sit down. Stand up. Samar. What you have learned about Nelson Mandela? Sit down. He was the first black president of South Africa. After long years of struggle that he has overcome the policy of apartheid, right? And it is for the first time that in South Africa, this ceremony has been organized in which the first black president is going to take the oath, right? So you can see very well that I have asked from 3 to 4, some are quiet. From number of students and still you people are blank. And if I make you revise the chapter, you will say, ma'am, hame to sara hi aata. Now I will ask side by side. Okay, so what this chapter is about, as I told you that this chapter is about the policy of apartheid. Okay, what is the meaning of policy of apartheid? Racial discrimination on the basis of color, especially. Yes? Yes, discrimination among black and whites. Earlier, this kind of discrimination did not exist, but it was at particular time that this kind of discrimination has started, and ultimately people were so much discriminated that they were not allowed to share the same place, or they were not allowed. Some of you come here. Otherwise, you keep on talking. Please come here. Then be quiet. Okay. So this did not start at a particular time when the people started discrimination, and they were not allowing to share the same kind of places. They were not enjoying equal rights. Although black people, they are also inhabitants. Their native place is South Africa, but still in their own country, they are living like refugees, or they are living the life of some guests only, right? Who are from outside the country. So this chapter, it starts with the special ceremony. What this special ceremony was? Yes, Britta, your name? Palak, tell me which ceremony is mentioned in the chapter? Oath taking ceremony. Where it has taken place? Keshav, sit down, please. Where it has taken place? Sit down, next one. In the Union Buildings of Pretoria. Okay, Union Buildings of Pretoria. So this chapter, it starts with the description. It is an account written by Nelson Mandela himself. And he has mentioned that on that day, when I was sitting in the Union Buildings of Pretoria, and at that time, what has happened? The ceremony, oath-taking ceremony of South Africa's first black president is going to take place. And he was surrounded by a number of dignitaries from almost 140 different countries. The dignitaries have arrived there. It was really an appreciable as well as admirable moment for him also. And moreover, what he said, that the world leaders, they have come to pay their respect to this grand ceremony and to this ceremony which is going to take place. And it is first ever in the history of this world that international leaders, they have arrived in South Africa to pay their respect to this newly formulated government, which is democratically elected. right? So clear where this ceremony took place? This ceremony took place in the Union Buildings of Pretoria. So, and in Union Buildings of Pretoria, where it has particularly taken place? Where it has particularly taken place in Union Buildings, or what is amphitheater, right? Sit down. Okay, it has taken place in the amphitheater of the Union Buildings of Pretoria. And why this ceremony was special, Madhav? Why this? You can say, but this is an after effect, because this was a seat of white supremacy. Sit down, please. Because this was a seat of white supremacy for such a long time. And for many years back, only white people, they have taken oath in these buildings. And it is for the first time that it was a place of white people to take oath. And it is for the first time that the black people, they have come, or the black president has come here to take oath. And it was, of course, paying its respect to the rainbow gathering. What is rainbow gathering mentioned here? What Ekjot will tell me. Yes, Ekjot. Very good. Sit down, please. So it means that people of different races, different countries, they have come there in order to pay their respect to this newly formulated government. Who was accompanying him during this ceremony? Who was accompanying Nelson Mandela, Vrinda? Sit down next. Daksh, who was accompanying Nelson Mandela in the family? His daughter, Zinani. Okay, sit down, please. Be attentive and remind. Please revise again side by side. His daughter Zinani was also present along with him. And when he has on the podium, okay, on the stage, first of all, who has taken the oath? First of all, the second deputy president, Mr. De Klerk, he has taken the oath. It was followed by the oath taking ceremony of the first deputy president, that is Thabo Mbeki. And during the elections, why it was a great win on part of Nelson Mandela? It was because of the reason that he has won 252 out of 400 seats in South Africa. And that was really a great win for the black people. So now, then when he has, after that, he after the oath-taking ceremony of both these two ministers, presidents, then it was the turn of Nelson Mandela as the president of newly formulated Palak. Right? So finally, what he has mentioned in his speech. Now listen to me carefully. What he has mentioned in speech. Anshika, can you tell what he has mentioned in his speech? Okay, so he has mentioned, of course, this also, what she has told. But before starting coming to the actual point of his speech, he has come up with, first of all, paying his respect to the crowning glory or the hope or the newborn liberty that has been achieved by the country. So first of all, what he did, he paid his respect towards the glory and hope of the newborn liberty of the country. So at that time, he has mentioned about an extraordinary human disaster. Okay, so what is this human disaster? Your name? Satvik, chalo batao. What was that human disaster? Why it is called as human disaster? But why, Raghav, why it was called as human disaster?
Because there was no special incident discriminated on the basis of race.
Close it down, please. Anybody else? Why it was called as human disaster? Sit down, please. Both of you. It was called as human disaster because it is inflicted by humans on humans. And why it is called as disaster? It is because of this reason that it has affected greater number of people ever in the history of the world. Okay, this is the reason. It started with men upon men. Inflicted by men upon men. And it has affected the greatest number of people in the history. So this is the reason why it is called as human disaster. Okay. So coming out of the experience of this great human disaster, he has mentioned that now today, the humanity will definitely be proud of the efforts that has been put. Okay, so then afterwards he thanked all the dignitaries who has come from far and near countries to pay their respect to this newly formulated government, and he has also welcomed the distinguished guests or international distinguished guests present there. Then he has also talked about political emancipation. Simarpreet, what is political emancipation? He is going to say, ma'am, many bol raha, wo bol raha. I think you need to. Yes, what is political emancipation? Very bad. Vineet Roop, what is political emancipation? File iski le lo. Yes, what is political emancipation? What is political emancipation? Sit down, Kanishka. Freedom from restrictions which were politically imposed upon them. Okay, liberty, political freedom, political liberty. Okay, political freedom from all the shackles they were bound for so many years, almost 100 decades. Okay, so this is what he has talked about, that he has also talked about political emancipation that they have got at that very moment. And he also pledged that he will liberate all the people of his country from any kind of poverty, deprivation, suffering, gender, or any other kind of discrimination. He said that he would never let his people suffer from any kind of discrimination that is going to take place in their country. Then afterwards, he has also mentioned that never ever again that this kind of oppression will be faced by any person of the world. So after his speech, when he has paid a glance towards the sky, he has noticed various kind of aeroplanes showing, or especially South African jets, helicopters and troop carriers. What are the three? Keshav, be quiet. Don't disturb her. Please be quiet. So now he has seen that South African jets, troop carriers, as well as helicopters, they were presenting a spectacular show of the planes with the trails of different colors giving out in the form of smoke, right? So what this represents? This doesn't represent only the precision, okay, means accuracy of their flight, but what it really depicts, it depicts their, you can say, loyalty towards the newly formulated government that they are showing, or it was a demonstration of the military loyalty towards the newly formulated government, which is democratically elected. Okay, and after that also, he has also seen some South African generals who were saluting him. Earlier, he has faced great amount of atrocities from these kind of generals who have pushed him towards his, you can say, towards his limits. Sometimes he felt broken also, right? But at this time, when those generals whose chest they were bedecked with ribbons as well as medals, so they have come here there in order to, you can say, pay their respect towards him, then ultimately, what's going on? Then ultimately what has happened, he felt that again it is a sign of loyalty towards this newly formulated government. Kirti, yes, what I have explained now? Stand up. What I have explained? Your voice is not audible to me. Please speak again. You people shout at the top of your voices if you want to do anything, but if I will ask you a question, that means your voice will never raise from your throat because there is lack of confidence to what I'm saying is right or not. Sit down, please. Next, Vanshika. Same thing again. No answer. And this is the revision work going on. What I have explained, how the loyalty to the newly formulated government is shown. How loyalty to the newly formulated government is shown. Huh? हाँ कुछ क्या बताया था? आई स्पोक फॉर ऑलमोस्ट 5 मिनट्स एंड यू आर सेइंग मैम कुछ बताया था, क्या बताया था? चलो बताओ. यस सार्थक स्टैंड अप नाउ. समर्थ कम हियर, कम हियर. No, I have not taught this. Okay, how this loyalty was shown? Tell me this thing. Yes. Yes, by show. The generals, they were saluting him. This was the way to show the loyalty towards this newly formulated government. Okay, so after that, he remembered that chevron of Impala jets, they were giving out a trail of black, red, green, blue and gold. Okay, why only these colors? Because these were the colors of South African flag. Okay, so why these colors were given out? Because these were the colors of South African flag. So this day was special. Why this day was special? This day was symbolized by playing of the national anthems of both the nations, that is of whites as well as that of blacks. Okay, so the both the national anthems. Baljinder, aapke, who is sitting with you? Harsimran? Ash, idhar aa jao, Purinder. Chalo aap udhar. You come here. And Virinda, by the end of this chapter, you are going to explain. Okay, so both these national anthems were played, that is of whites as well as that of black, that is Nikosi Sikkelel and Dai Stem. And they both were not remembering the name, remembering the exact words or the lyrics of the national anthems, but soon they will remember. It means soon they will adapt the culture of each other. Okay, then on that very day, he was overwhelmed with the sense of history. He remembered the special points of history, that when the Anglo-Boer War, it broke. Okay. And at that moment, he said that the white South African people, they have started a special kind of discrimination against black people. Out of nowhere means out of, he said, I don't remember when this has started and why it has started. But he remembered that it was at the time of Anglo-Boer War when this kind of discrimination, it started. Now, finally, he said, now in the last decade of this 20th century and almost 8 decades of his life. Okay, so what he has said, he said that he has seen number of ways how different people, they have undergone different kind of struggles. They have undergone different kinds of oppressions. And it is because of their continued struggle, they were able to overcome this kind of oppression that has lasted for many generations upon their nation. Okay, so he has also remembered the sacrifices of the thousands of the martyrs, thousands of his people who have put in their suffering as well as their courage, which has resulted into this great day. Okay, so he said that he was really pained. He was really feeling sad, or he was feeling really pained that those people who have put their strong sacrifices, who have put their honest sacrifices in bringing this day to this nation, ultimately they are not there in order to see what result their sacrifices has wrought. Okay, so why Nelson Mandela was pained on that day also, or why he was why does he have a feeling of or a sense of pain on that very day? Yes, second boy, your name? Krishna. Yes, Krishna. Why he was pained, or why he was feeling a sense of pain on that day? He could never repay them, of course. Okay, and it was the result of the cumulative effect. Okay, it was the result of the cumulative effect of the sacrifices. Sit down, please. Kindly be attentive. Okay, that has been put in by them. So at that moment, he remembered that what kind of hurt, what kind of deep effect this kind of discrimination, which is called as apartheid, it has among people. It has a profound hurt, means very deep hurt. And at that time, he has remembered various great leaders of South Africa named Oliver Tambo, Walter Sisulu, Chief Lutyens, and Yusuf Dadda. Okay, and from the lives of all these great men, okay, what he has come to know? He has come to know that this kind of greatness of character, how it is achieved? That this kind of greatness of character, it is achieved by the great kind of oppression that they have undergone. Okay, and it is not easy to achieve these heights of character. How they are achieved? Because of the great oppressions that they have undergone. Then he paying respect to the people of his country, what he has said, that the actual wealth of his country are not the minerals or the gemstones or the diamonds. What are the actual wealth of his country? The people of his country are the truest wealth for him. Okay, then he has also learned an important lesson throughout his life that he has shared at that time. What he said, that what is the meaning of courage? What is the meaning of courage? Yes, very good. But overcoming it. Okay, what is courage? It is not actually the absence of fear, but it is a triumph over it. It is a victory over courage. So what is, yes, Vanshika, what is courage according to him that he has learned? Yes, good. You can speak. Yes. Okay, speak a word. I will complete it. Ashima. Yes, of course, it is not actually the absence of fear, but actually what it is a victory over it. It is a triumph over it. So, he has also mentioned as hate is natural, love is also natural, okay? If someone is not told to hate, so one can also be taught to love, okay? Love can also be taught to people. And with this only, what he said that when he was in jail, he was pushed towards his limits. He has faced the extreme brutalities, harsh treatments at the hands of the generals as well as the guards. He said, even just for a second, okay, even just for a second, I have seen some humanity in the eyes of a guard. Even it was just a glimpse. But then he said, that was the thing that kept me going. Okay, and ultimately what he has said, then he has said that man's goodness is actually a flame which can never be hidden. Okay, which can be hidden but never extinguished. It means every human being has goodness, although the man tries to hide it. But ultimately, he said, it can be hidden, but it can never be extinguished. Then he has also talked about twin obligations. This you all know. What kind of twin obligations? One is family and other towards the nation. In family, towards his parents, towards his wife, towards his children. He has. And the other one he has for towards his nation. But what he said that a person like him, he was never allowed to fulfill both these type of obligations. Why? He was forced to leave behind. And then talking about his freedom, he has talked about that the sense of freedom or the actual meaning of freedom, it has also changed for him. Because earlier what he has thought freedom is to cook melis and to run at the back of the bulls, to have a dive into the stream of water. This was just freedom. Later on, when he has grown up, he has thought that reading a book of his own choice, to spend a night with his friends, is actually freedom. But while in Johannesburg, he has to fight in order to earn his keep according to his caliber. Okay, to live a married life peacefully. When he thought that he was not able to fulfill all these requisites of freedom in a lawful manner, then at that moment he came to know that his freedom is already ripped away from him. It means that the freedom that he was enjoying earlier was not actually the real freedom. He was having a false notion of freedom. And he has also come to know that until and unless the people of his country, they are not free to enjoy their rights, he will never enjoy his freedom. If they are in shackles, if they are in chains, he would also feel himself in chains. And it was at that moment that he has joined African National Congress. So after joining this, and when he has his changed sense of freedom, This has completely made him a changed man. So how he has turned out to be a changed man? How he has turned out to be a changed man? From a law-abiding attorney, he has changed into a criminal. From a family-loving person, he was forced to live a life of seclusion, separation. Okay, from a family-loving husband, he turned into a man without home. It means his life has entirely changed. So, at the last, he has talked about the oppressor and the oppressed. He said that if the oppressor is under the burden of the, if the oppressed is under the burden of the atrocities given by the oppressor, even the oppressor is not free. Why he is not free? It is because of the reason that he is also not free. It is because of the reason he was under the burden of his own hatred, of his own prejudices, of his own narrow-mindedness that he has to come out at that time. Okay, so both the persons, they are having the same fate and they both are having the same kind of cages in which they were bound to, oppressor and oppressor, right? So finally, with this note, he has finally given an end to his, experiences. And through this chapter, he has given a complete view of his life, right? So that's all that we have to do today. And now, after that, I'm going to do Tiger in the Zoo. Okay, as the time is not allowing us, so we are not going to start it now. Yes, I'm going to tell you, please note.